In Jesus' name, we bless you and honor you for everything and in everything. And we ask in Jesus' name, somebody say amen. Let's come together as we get to a moment of sharing the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we adore you. We live our life before you. How we love you, Lord. Father, we adore you. We live our lives before you. How we love you. Jesus, Jesus, we adore you. We live our lives before you. How we love precious Jesus, Jesus, we adore you. We live our life before you. How we love you. Come and lean, oh, Holy Spirit. We welcome you to come and reign. Come and reign, come and reign. Holy Spirit, we welcome you to come and reign. Come and heal, come and heal. Holy Spirit, we welcome you to come and heal. Come and heal our minds, come and heal. Oh, Holy Spirit, we welcome you to come and heal. Lord, have your way. We bless your name, Jesus.
Jesus.
We welcome your presence, Holy Spirit. Welcome in our midst. Welcome your goodness, O Lord. Give us a heart for you, Lord. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. We bless your name. Oh, my God. We bow before your throne. We bless your name. We bless your name, oh my God. We bow before your throne. We bless your name, we bless your name. Oh, Lift up your hands and give him a clap of praise this morning. Let his name be magnified. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Lift up your hand. Say, dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
Today,
I submit to you.
Open my eyes.
Open my
understanding.
May you cause me.
To worship you.
As I should.
In Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Amen and amen.
Are you expecting from the Lord today?
Yes.
Do you come here with the heart of expectation?
Yes.
Do you come with the heart of thanksgiving?
Yes.
Okay, Sasa. Let's get seated. Let's get into a moment of the word. Hi. Now, I want to go straight away to the word of the Lord because of our time. One of the things I'm praying and God is going to help us is that we are going to have to break one of the things that we call the spirit of rancidity. You know, when people take the things of God and at times we come to the house of God, like, you know, we are not much in a hurry. It's like we have got, there is a spirit of rancidity ambayo ikiingia mahali katika nyumba ya Mungu inazuiliaga baraka za Mungu. I'm telling you, spirit of rancidity, ile roho ya ku. Rancidity sana ni nini? Kuzembea. Roho ya uzembe. Na uregevu. Na uzoevu. But when those spirits interfere, then they make people miss their blessing. And that is what I want to talk about. Come with me to the book of Mark. I'm going to give you the three portions where, because this is one of the Mark 16, 24 to 26. Come with me. Mark 16, verse 24 to 26. Mark chapter 16, verse 24. Do you have that, by the way? Then I have misquoted. Matthew chapter 16, verse 24 of the book of Matthew. Please read with me if you can. 1, 2, 3. Then Jesus said to his disciples, if anyone would come after me, he must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. Continue verse 25 and 6. For whoever wants to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for me will find it. Verse number 26 says, what good will it be for a man if he gains the whole world, yet for faith is so? What a sick way. Or what can a man give in exchange for his life? Thank God so much. Our new, the new guy who took over from Githu Muigai?
Paul Kihara.
Right now he is the AG. Yeah, when he was being interviewed, he gave this scripture as his reference. When he was talked about the use of Quran, he said, what will it benefit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? I think that was powerful. What a CPU. Yeah. Now, before that, let's go back to verse number 24. It says this, verse number 24. Jesus said and said to his disciples, if anyone would come after me, he must deny himself. Now, in this session, normally we like talking about ministry. And one of the things that you need to understand about ministry, please hear me, is that number one, if you want to serve God, you are desired a good thing. If you want to be found in the house of God and serve God and do the things of God, you desire a good thing. But there is that it takes. It takes, number one, what we call self-denial. That means when you deny yourself, it means you are not willing to walk in certain kind of walk or do things in a certain kind of way. You means there are things you got to put aside and you deny yourself so that you may take up your cross and follow Christ. Christ took his own cross, went to Golgotha. He was crucified, died and rose again. And he says, whoever wants to follow me must take his own cross. That means if I have a family, then that family should not hinder me from serving God. If I have a business, it should not hinder me from serving God. If I have got, I'm in a relationship, if I have a job, if I have a career, if whatever I have, it is need to be, that is my cross, and I am able to take control of it. I at times get surprised At times I get surprised when I find the commitment that I find in the religious people. Eh? Mapema saa moja alfajiri mapema utakutana na wamama na amebeba mtoto na kuingine ameshika hivi anakimbia kwa sababu anaenda katika kwenda kanisani. Watu wa dini wako na commitment kubwa kuhusu mambo ambao wanaamini kuliko watu ambao ni wa At times I get when I'm on Isri. At Isri, sijui on Friday and you fight between saa sita na saa nane. Uwezi nunua wanafunga duka zote wanafunga na kuna watu ambao wana nini na wengine wale wanachelewa wanafunga toka bana wewe siku nuzi wanafunga haraka because they are supposed to go there wanakataa pesa eh wanataki pesa sasa hizo because it is time to go kwa msikiti na kwenda kusali kufanya kuswali na kweli kabisa unajua hao watu kile ambacho wanaenda kuswali kabisa it is totally out of context of what you believe and yet there is such a commitment and that is what we need to understand we Pentecostal so called people we need to be very careful Bwana tukuzwe sana one of the things I've never been felt ever proud about being called is to be called charismatic or Pentecostal because it does not carry anything if at all it means nothing to you and we got to have a craving and a desire that we are going to rise up and serve God in a different way if we want to see the hand of God in our life amen whoever want to follow me must deny themselves take up their cross and follow me now when we talk about that following the cross of Jesus we are connected with a man in Matthew 27:32 come to Matthew 27:32 I show you one guy who carried the cross of Jesus and you know him as well as I do. Everybody read with me 1, 2, 3. As they were going out, they met a man from Cyrene. You heard? His name was who? Simon. And they forced him to carry the cross of who? To carry the cross of Jesus. Now, this man is a very good study case. If